So with all the talk today about internet privacy, you may be wondering how you can protect your privacy while surfing online. And using Safari is a great option right off the bat because it's going to do some privacy protections by preventing these tracking networks from tracking you from day to day. This is something that you won't get, for instance, Google Chrome, because of course Google Chrome is tied to Google's ad networks, so it's kind of against their interests to do that. But Safari gives you that. But what can you do that's even more than that? There are Safari extensions that will help with privacy as well. Let's take a look at one. So I'm going to go to Safari, Safari Extensions, and you can search here for DuckDuckGo, or in this case it's right on page 2. There's DuckDuckGo Privacy Essentials. We're going to take a look at that one. I'm going to hit the Install Now button. Now DuckDuckGo you may recognize because they're a search engine. Matter of fact, if I go to Safari Preferences and I look at search, you could see it's one of the search engines I can choose as the default. Now once I've installed the Privacy Essentials, I get a little button up here with a letter in it, like C. Let's go to another site. Let's go to Apple's homepage here, and you can see it has B in there. If I click on that, I get a little report of how privacy is kind of graded on this page. It looks at a bunch of things. One, it looks to see if there's encryption on the page. In other words, it's an HTTPS site rather than HTTP, which is unencrypted. It's going to get a pretty bad grade if it's not encrypted. Then it looks at tracker networks found. In this case, zero are found. Apple doesn't have any ads on their own site. They're not doing any special tracking like using third-party networks to track statistics or anything. So there's nothing there. The only thing to keep it from getting an A is unknown privacy practices. And it looks like almost every website, I can't find a single website except the DuckDuckGo website itself, that will actually have something here. So it looks like there's some sort of system that nobody's really using yet. So a B is the highest grade I can see outside of the DuckDuckGo website anywhere. Matter of fact, if I even go to Wikipedia, which doesn't use anything really, it's secure and there's no tracker networks and all of that, it still just gets a B. So B seems to be pretty much the highest grade you can expect. So let's go to another site here. Let's go to MacMost. And you can see MacMost also gets a B. And if I click there, notice a few things. First it says enhanced from C to B. What does that mean? Well, this extension is doing more than just giving you a grade. It's also blocking tracker networks. So tracker networks are things that basically store a cookie and kind of track you. And it's blocking one tracker network at MacMost. And by doing so, it's enhancing the grade from a C to a B. If tracking is turned off, and I can do that with this switch right here, then it would be a C grade. Now, you can get more information about the tracker network. In this case, it's just a tracker network that's tracking statistics for me for the newsletter. So how many people are clicking on links in the newsletter. It's not doing what the concerning trackers are, you know, the ones that kind of invade your privacy by, say, tracking your preferences and serving up ads and things like that. This is just statistics for the website owner. As a matter of fact, there's a few on here. If I refresh the page, maybe it'll pick them up. Yeah, so now it says 2. You can see it's also showing Google Analytics, which is just statistics, how many people visit each page on the site, and YouTube, which is how many people are viewing each video. So these are pretty harmless compared to, say, ad networks. Let's take a look at my local newspaper here, which I know has a lot of ads on it. And it also shows a B, but it's enhanced from a D to a B. And it's blocking 9 tracker networks. And you can see these are, a lot of them are things that are tracking your advertising preferences and things like that. So you're getting information here about the grade, and you're also getting these tracker networks being blocked, which is nice and enhances your privacy. If you decide that by blocking these tracker networks, it's somehow disabling something on the website, it's messing with the website, which is it's possible. Anytime something is blocking something on a website, it could be doing it in a fashion that disables the site. So you can always turn off blocking. And now you can see by doing so, it reloads the page. It gives me the grade of D now. And I can always click here for settings. And under settings, I could see that it's a whitelisted site now. So I could turn it off. So now that site is no longer, it's going back to blocking the tracking on that site as it was before. Extensions like this are easy to install. You can see how easy it was. In addition, it's also easy to disable. If by going to the Preferences, going to Extensions, and I could turn it off. And I can also hit the Uninstall button very easily. So you could give this a try, see if it's something that you want going on. One of the things that I don't like about it is it seems to reset your searches. So I'm always searching through DuckDuckGo, even if my default search engine is Google. And I don't like that because while I do like DuckDuckGo for the privacy stuff, I really want to see what Google is showing when I'm doing some research for things. So there are pros and cons there.